Dearly beloved, the message that God has given me this morning, when God calls you, people chase you. When God calls you, people chase you. This is the message God gave me this morning. Turn with me to book of John chapter 11 verse 14. Book of John, chapter 1. Book of John chapter 1 verse 11. He came to his own did not receive him. He came to his own did not receive him. When Jesus, he is Almighty God, he created the man, and he became a flesh and dwelt among us, and he came to the people in this world, and they didn't receive him. They rejected him, and they didn't want to accept him. And also Jesus said, when we go to the world, if people are not expecting us, they are not expecting God. He said, if they are rejecting you, they are also rejecting me. And so many servants of God whom God has chosen, they were rejected by the people. Moses, Paul, all the prophets, and all the chosen anointed ones were rejected by the people. But God allowed that to happen in order to keep them alone with him, in order to have personal relationship with him and lead him. Now, turn with me to book of Exodus. I'm going to read many chapters. I'm not going to read chapter by chapter. I'm going to tell you the story. When God gave birth, when God brought Moses, baby Moses, to this world, his mother couldn't keep him because the Pharaoh, King Pharaoh, wants to kill all the children among the Hebrews in Egypt, as he couldn't find who Moses was. He killed many children, and Moses' mother was only able to protect him for 3 months. After 3 months, you know the story, and if you don't know the story, read from the book of Exodus from chapter 1. And he made, I will read only few words from chapter 1, Exodus chapter 1. To the people who has never heard about it. Exodus chapter 2, verse 2. But when she could not longer hid him, she took an ark of bushes for him, dumped in with a spit and pitch, put the children, a child in it, and laid in it reeds by the river's bank. Now what he did, he kept that child in the small ark that he made out of a bush, and kept in the Nile River, and not knowing what will happen to the child, but she has to send him that way through the river in order to protect his life. But she didn't know what will happen, and she has to chase him from the house in order to protect him. Not that she didn't love her child, and also nothing is saying about the father, Moses' father, and also sister went and watched what is happening to the brother, and the Pharaoh's daughter picked the child and took her to the Pharaoh's palace. Pharaoh was trying to destroy him and kill him. God sent him into the same palace to protect him, and also God gave the opportunity for his own mother to come and take him and feed him for many months till he become a child, and then brought and hand over him back to Pharaoh's daughter. Now he was in the palace, and till 40 years he got everything, best of everything in Egypt, and he got good training, and he was good, he got a good education, he fed well, he was like a prince in the Pharaoh's house, but he was not a prince. Purpose of God in his life was different. And one day he went out to see his brothers working, as they were working very hard as slaves. He was so sorry. The desire started in his belly to deliver them from the slavery. A fire begins to burn in his belly, and through that fire, burning started to come into his heart and mind, and he wants to deliver the Hebrews from slavery, from Egypt. And he didn't know how to do it, but he got the desire. And as he was watching that, he suddenly saw one Egyptian is beating one of the Hebrew men. He jumped and he tried to stop. He couldn't make, he was unable to stop him because he was going to kill him. And then what he did, he looked around, there was nobody to see. And he killed that Egyptian and hid him under the sand, as he thought that nobody saw it. The next day, and again he saw two of the Hebrews were fighting. He went to stop. He's trying to bring harmony among the brothers. And as he was saying to stop that, see what the Hebrew men said. The verse 14. Then he said, "Who made you a priest and a judge over us? Do you intend to kill me as you kill the Egyptians?" So Moses feared and said, "Surely this thing is known." Now Moses thought nobody knew that he killed one of the Egyptians. Now to see, all know that he has killed one man. As Pharaoh came to know that, he was searching to kill Moses. Now Moses have to get out from the place. What was the reason that he has to get out from the Egyptian? His own brothers betrayed him. As he was chosen, he wants to help his brothers. He wants to help his own brothers, Hebrews. And they rejected him. They didn't want to accept him. They were angry with him. He was trying to bring harmony among the brothers. Now they rejected him. They didn't want him. They hate him. This is what happened to all the servants of God whom God has called. Servants of God wants to bring harmony and peace among the chosen brothers and sisters. They chase them, they hate them, they reject them. Now because of this, he has to run away from Egyptians, otherwise the Pharaoh will kill him. But I want you to know, my beloved, from the birth of his life, the hand of the Lord was there. It is God who used his mother to send him in the Nile River. And also it is God who appointed Pharaoh's daughter to pick him and looked after him till 40 years old. He was well educated, strong man. He was a general of the army. He had all the powers and knowledge, understanding, education, strength, with everything. Now he has to just leave the place and go, with knowing, not knowing where he was going. Now he's going out. As he was going, and he was tired and sat in the side, and he saw some people have come to collect the water to the animals, and the shepherds are trying to hinder some girls over there who has come to feed, to take water to the animals. He has to go and help them and deliver them from those bad people and help them draw water. And also, he also have to face some troubles in that place as he was trying to help somebody. And soon after he left from that place, the daughters of this man, seven daughters, they went and told the father, "Father, why you all came early today?" And they were explaining, "The father, there was a man from Egypt. He came and helped us. The way he was dressing, he was like Egyptian. The way he was eating like Egyptian. The way he was spoken, he was like Egyptian, but he was not an Egyptian. He was a Hebrew." And then the father said, "Bring him to give him a meal." To cut the story short, he gave one of his daughters to marry him. Now Moses thought, "I will never go back to Egypt. And I was almost about to kill by them. I was trying to help them, even though I had a desire to deliver them from the slavery. They themselves was trying to kill me, and they rejected me. They hate me. I will never go back. That is the end of my Egyptian trip. I will never turn back to the Egyptians." And now he is here with Midianites, and he settled himself in Midianite, got married, got a baby, and having a happy family life. And one day he was just going, as he was looking after the sheep in the Mount Horeb. It was a natural thing for bush to burn in the desert. Naturally, it happens always. Bushes get burned. But as he was going forward, suddenly he turned to see one of the bushes that it was burning, not consumed. He turned to see why it happened, and the bush was spoken to him through the bush. The bush says, "Moses, Moses, you're living in the holy ground, remove your shoes." And then the voice of God came, the burning bush. Now, the burning fire was in his stomach, in the belly. In his belly, the fire was burning from the day that he saw the Israelites were suffering in the slavery. That burning fire was burning constantly as he was looking after the sheep. And even though he's having a happy family life, even though he is separated from the Egyptian, but he had a desire, the burning desire in his belly to deliver them from the suffering. From their suffering. And as he goes, so this is the time that he's thinking about this. An idea is in his heart, has not gone away. So what God said spoke to him twice. When he says twice, "Moses, Moses," that was covenant. And then God called him, has said, "Go to Pharaoh and deliver my people. Tell them to deliver. They tell him to deliver my people. Send my people." And God said, "I will harden his heart. And he sent 10 plagues. And after the 10 plagues, he delivered them and brought with Moses. My beloved, as God has chosen Moses, he has chosen you and me. And nobody's going to put flowers around our neck and welcome. As we are facing so many trials and obstacles in our life, remember, as God has chosen us, he will be faithful till the end." As he used Moses to deliver the people, Israelites, from the slavery, he will use us to deliver the nations in this world, our own people in our nation, to deliver them from their slavery of sin and Satan. He has anointed us. If you have the burning desire in your belly, as the bush was burning, the fire of the Holy Spirit is burning in our belly. If God has called us to deliver the people from the out of darkness to the kingdom of God, therefore, be faithful even though the people try to chase you. don't get hard in your heart, don't get hurt, don't get discouraged, don't give up. Go forth as God has chosen you in the 21st century. He wants to change the world by using us to destroy the work of the enemy in this world. May God help you to understand this message and say, God has chosen me. I will not leave, as God said, He will never leave me nor forsake me, even unto the end of this world. I will not leave. I will not die. I will not give up. I will continue with the ministry that God has called me. I will be faithful to the calling and to the heavenly vision that God has given me till the end of my life. May God bless you. I call upon Brother Christopher to come and pray and ask God to help the congregation to be faithful as people are trying to chase him. But let God, the Holy Spirit, lead him.